Hello everyone, welcome in the next lecture of integral equations. Okay, so in the previous lecture we are going to study the method for finding solution of non-homogeneous Friedholm integral equation of second kind with separable kernel. Okay, so in today's lecture we are going to study the another method for finding solution of non-homogeneous Friedholm integral equation of second kind. Okay, with separable kernel. The method is variational iteration method. In the previous lecture, we see the method, that is noise terms phenomena method. Okay, so this variational iteration method works effectively. This method works effectively if the kernel, K of xt is of separable form, We know that what is the separable form, that is K of xt must be equal to g of x into h of t in this form. So in the variational iteration method, we differentiate first. Differentiate given Friedholm integral equation with respect to x on both the sides, and also when both the sides, when the initial condition should be derived. Okay, so here first we write the standard form of Friedholm integral equation. We know that what is the standard form, that is u of x is equal to f of x plus lambda integration from a to b k of x t into u of t dt. This is the standard Friedholm integral equation. Okay, so here we differentiate both the sides, with respect to x. Before that we put here value of the kernel. This is g of x into h of t, that is u of x is equal to f of x plus lambda integration from a to b k of x t, can be write g of x into h of t u of t dt. Okay, so we get here f of x plus lambda. If we take g of x outside, because which is constant with respect to t, then we get here a to b h of t into u of t dt. Okay, then we differentiate both the sides with respect to x. So by differentiate both sides with respect to x, we get derivative of u of x will be u dash of x is equal to derivative of f of x will be f dash of x. Okay, plus see here lambda will be constant g, and also this integral which is only depends on variable t. Okay, so this is the constant with respect to x. So here only function in x, that is g of x, these are the constant. So we can take only derivative of this g of x. This will be as it is. So we get here lambda g dash of x integration from a to b h of t into u of t dt will be as it is, because which is the constant with respect to x. Otherwise we know that how to find the derivative under the, or how to take the differentiation under the integral sign by using the Leibniz rule. We can see that in first chapter. Okay, then we can write this as u dash of x minus f dash of x minus lambda g dash of x integration from a to b h of t into u of t dt is equal to 0. Okay, so and in variational iteration method we have to use variational iteration method we have to use correction functional for integral differential equation. Okay, so we write here correction functional for this integral differential equation, that is un plus 1 of x is equal to un of x plus integration from 0 to x lambda of xi in bracket. We have to write this integral differential equation in terms of xi, that is u dash of xi minus f dash of xi minus lambda g dash of xi. Okay, integration from a to b, here we write in terms of r, that is h of r un r dr and this bracket complete into d xi. Okay, then here pair lambda of xi, where lambda of xi is a Lagrange's multiplier. Okay. In this chapter we have to use the value of lambda of xi, that is Lagrange's multiplier will be lambda of xi is equal to, we have to use minus 1 for first order integral differential equation. Here we differentiate only one times, so we get the first order integral differential equation. So we use here lambda of xi is equal to minus 1, that is Lagrange's multiplier. If we put lambda of xi is equal to minus 1 in this correction functional, then this correctional function becomes put in above equation, this equation becomes un plus 1 of x is equal to un of x. If we put lambda of xi is equal to minus 1, then we get here minus integration from 0 to x in bracket u dash of xi minus f dash of xi minus lambda g dash of xi integration from a to b h of r into un of r dr bracket complete into d of xi. Okay, so this is the correction functional for the standard Friedmann integral equation of second kind. Okay. For solving problems, we have to find first this correctional functional for a given integral equation. So that is for given Friedmann integral equation. Okay, so here we use the value of g of x. We take the value of city we study in the chapter only cases when g of x is equal to x raised to n for n greater than or equal to 1. Okay, otherwise g of x is in another form also. Okay, then here this correctional functional gives only the successive approximations, not the components. So correction functional gives successive approximations not the components. Okay, in another methods, that is we have to study, that is modified decomposition method, then Adamant decomposition method, Nystrom's phenomena. We find the components U0x, U1x, then we take their addition, infinite components and their addition, then we use the infinite geometric series or Thales series to find the solution. But here in this variational iteration method, by using correction functional, we have to get the successive approximations, and using that successive approximation we have to find the value of that successive approximation at n tends to infinity to get the solution. So we get solution by taking limit at n tends to infinity un of x. If we take the limit of n tends to infinity un of x, then we get the solution, that is u of x of the given Friedel integral equation of second kind. Okay. Then we see one example on that method. Okay. So here we write the example. So use the variational iteration method to solve the Friedel integral equation. We have to given that Friedel integral equation is u of x is equal to, we write again, u of x is equal to x into e raised to x minus x plus x integration from 0 to 1 u of t dt. Okay, then by using variational iteration method, first we have to differentiate this equation with respect to x on both sides. So first we differentiate both sides with respect to x, the above integral equation. So we get here derivative of u of x will be u dash of x is equal to derivative of x into e raised to x, we write here d by dx x e raised to x. Okay, minus derivative of x will be 1, so we get here minus 1 plus, see here again, here integration 0 to 1 u of t into dt is in terms of t, so which is the constant with respect to x. So we can take here 0 to 1 u of t dt as it is, and derivative of x with respect to x is 1, so we get derivative will be this. Okay, so here we use the product rule to find this derivative. X will be as it is, derivative of e raised to x will be e raised to x plus e raised to x as it is, derivative of x will be 1. Okay, then minus 1 plus integration from 0 to 1 u of t dt, we get this is the first order integral differential equation. Okay, so this is the, we get first order integral differential equation. Integral differential equation. Okay, then we find the initial condition for this by put x is equal to 0. Give it as equation number 1, given equation, put x is equal to 0 in 1. If we put x is equal to 0 in given equation, we get u of 0 is equal to, here first term becomes 0, that is 0 into e raised to 0 minus 0 plus 0 integration from 0 to 1 u of t dt. So we get here u of 0 is equal to 0 be the initial condition for the first order integral differential equation. Okay, then we write the integral differential equation, rho differential equation in the form of integral differential equation becomes, we can shift all these terms in LHS, we get u dash of x minus x into e raised to x, minus becomes plus 1, minus integration from 0 to 1, u of t dt is equal to 0. Then we have to use this form for writing the correction functional for this integral differential equation. Then the correction functional for this integral differential equation is we get un plus 1 of x. We see here theory how to write the correction function. Un plus 1 of x is equal to un of x minus, here always take minus for first order integral differential equation, integration from 0 to x, and in bracket we have to write this equation in terms of xi, that is instead of x we have to write the xi, and here instead of t we have to write the r. So we get here u dash of xi minus xi e raised to xi plus 1 minus integration from 0 to 1 u of r, that is we have to write here un of r dr, okay, into d xi for successive approximation. Okay, then we find the successive approximations. For that, for finding successive approximations, we select first approximation, that is we select u0 of x, that is initial approximation will be equal to u of 0, and v of 0 we can find which is equal to 0. So initial approximation we have to get u0 of x is equal to 0 be the initial approximation. That is the initial condition of the given Friedel integral differential equation is the first initial approximation for this correctional function. Okay. Then if we put for n is equal to 0 in this correctional functional, take it as equation number 2. Then for n is equal to 0 in 2, the equation number 2 becomes, we get the second approximation u1 of x is equal to u0 of x minus integration from 0 to x, in bracket we get u dash of xi minus xi e raised to xi plus 1 minus integration from 0 to 1 u0 of r to xi. Okay, so we get u1 of x is equal to u0 of x minus integration from 0 to x. Here u0 of x will be 0. Okay. So u0 of x will be 0. We write here u0 of x will be 0. So we get u0 dash of x will be 0. That is u0 of xi will be 0. So this term will be 0 minus xi e raised to xi plus 1 minus integration from 0 to 1 u0 of r will be again 0 into dr d xi. Okay, so we get u1 of x is equal to u0 of x, we can put here value of u0 of x also, will be 0 minus integration from 0 to x, here in bracket minus xi e raised to xi plus 1 this integral becomes 0, so remainder only into this side. Okay, then we solve this integral, we get u1 of x is equal to, so we get u1 of x is equal to, if we multiply this minus sign inside the bracket and also we separate the integral, we get integration from 0 to x xi e raised to xi d xi, minus minus becomes plus, again this minus minus becomes plus, we get plus integration from 0 to x e raised to xi d xi, then again minus integration from 0 to x d xi. Okay, then here we find this integral by using parts, so we get xi integration e raised to xi d xi minus integration of e raised to xi d xi into derivative of this xi with respect to xi, that is d xi by d xi into d xi. Okay, bracket complete, first integral complete, then plus integration of e raised to xi will be e raised to xi limits from 0 to x minus again integration of d xi will be xi limits from 0 to x. Okay, so is equal to here xi integration of e raised to xi will be e raised to xi minus derivative of this xi with respect to xi will be 1. If we take integration of e raised to xi 2 times, we get which is e raised to xi, that is minus e raised to xi, this complete limits from 0 to x plus, here if we put the limits, we get e raised to x minus e raised to 0 minus in bracket x minus 0. Okay, so is equal to, here again we put the limits, we get x e raised to x minus e raised to x, xi is equal to x, then by putting lower limit we put xi is equal to 0, this term becomes 0, minus minus this term becomes plus e raised to 0. Okay, then plus e raised to x e raised to 0 will be 1, so minus 1 minus x only is equal to x e raised to x minus e raised to x, e raised to 0 is 1, that is plus 1 plus e raised to x minus 1 minus x. Okay, so we get here minus e raised to x plus e raised to x gets cancelled, plus 1 minus 1 gets cancelled, we get u1 of x is equal to x into e raised to x minus x, which is the second approximation by using correctional function. Okay, then we find the next approximation by putting n is equal to 1. Before that we find u1 dash of x, because we have to use the derivative also in correctional functional. So we get u1 dash of x is equal to x by using product rule, here x derivative of e raised to x is e raised to x plus e raised to x, as it is derivative of x will be 1 and derivative of x will be minus 1. So we get u1 dash of x will be this. We have to use this in correctional function. So for n is equal to 1 in 2, that is in correctional functional, we get correctional functional becomes u2 for n is equal to 1, if we put, we get u2 of x is equal to u1 of x minus integration from 0 to x in bracket u1 dash of x minus xi e raised to xi minus e raised to xi plus 1 minus integration from 0 to 1 u 1 of r minus integration from 0 to 1 u 1 of r dr into d xi. Okay, so we put here values, we have to get u1 of x will be x e raised to x minus x. We put here x e raised to x minus integration from 0 to x u1 dash of x. We can find here u1 dash of x, that is x e raised to x plus e raised to x minus 1. We have to put this in terms of xi, sorry. So we get this is u1 dash of xi. We get minus integration from 0 to x. We have to write this in terms of xi. So from this we get xi e raised to xi plus e raised to xi minus 1. Then minus these terms xi e raised to xi minus e raised to xi plus 1. Okay, minus integration. We have to write all these in square bracket, sorry. Minus integration from 0 to 1. U1 of r, u of x will be x e raised to x minus x. So u1 of r will be r e raised to r minus r. Instead of x, we have to write r. Okay, dr, and this square bracket complete into d xi. Okay. Then we have to solve this. So x e raised to x minus integration from 0 to x. Here xi e raised to xi plus and minus gets cancelled, plus e raised to xi minus e raised to xi gets cancelled, minus 1 plus 1 gets cancelled. So this term becomes 0, remaining only minus integration from 0 to 1 in bracket r e raised to r minus r dr d xi. Okay, so is equal to x e raised to x minus x. This minus minus becomes plus. So we write here plus 0 to x. And we separate first this integral. So we get integration from 0 to 1 r e raised to r dr minus integration from 0 to 1 r dr bracket complete into d xi. This minus minus we can write here plus and only take this integration. Okay, so x e raised to x minus x plus integration from 0 to x as it is. Then again we have to take this integration by using parts. So r integration of e raised to r dr minus double integral e raised to r dr, derivative of this r with respect to r, that is dr by dr into integration dr into dr bracket complete minus integration of r will be r square divided by 2 from 0 to 1. Okay, also we write here another bracket, square bracket into this d xi. Okay, so we get here x e raised to x minus x plus integration from 0 to x. Here we can use curly bracket for differentiating this square bracket. So right here curly bracket. Okay, so in curly bracket, square bracket, r integration of e raised to r will be e raised to r minus double integral of e raised to r will be e raised to r, integral complete, limits from 0 to 1 minus, if we put here limits, we get 1 square, that is 1 by 2 minus 0 by 2, that is 0 by 2, bracket complete d xi. Okay, so is equal to again x e raised to x minus x plus integration from 0 to x as it is, curly bracket. In square bracket we put the limits 1 into e raised to 1 minus e raised to 1. By putting lower limit, if we put r is equal to 0 here, this term becomes 0, that is minus 0, minus minus becomes plus e raised to 0. Okay, then minus here only 1 by 2, curly bracket complete d xi. Okay, is equal to x e raised to x minus x plus integration from 0 to x. Then see here e minus e, 1 into e, this will be 0, e raised to 0, that is plus 1, and this minus 1 by 2 d psi. This plus e minus e gets cancelled. 1 minus 1 by 2 will be 1 by 2. Okay. So, we write here value of u2 of x. Okay. Then we get u2 of x is equal to x e raised to x minus x. Then 1 minus 1 by 2 will get here in integration 0 to x only 1 by 2 d psi. Okay. So x e raised to x minus x in plus 1 by 2 we take outside, integration of d psi will be psi limits from 0 to x. Then x e raised to x minus x plus 1 by 2 by putting limits we get here x minus 0. Okay. So we get x e raised to x minus x plus x by 2. This will be 0 and x by 2. Okay. So we get u2 of x is equal to x e raised to x minus x plus x by 2 we get here minus x by 2. Okay. This is the value of the third approximation. Okay. So here if we observe, we have to get u1 of x will be equal to x e raised to x minus x only. We have to get u2 of x will be x e raised to x minus x by 2. And if we find, continuing in this way, if we find u3 of x, then we have to get u3 of x is equal to x e raised to x minus x divided by 4. So we can write, continuing in this general form, we can write this as, this will be, we can write here x by 2 raised to 0, and here we write 2 raised to 1, or this, and this 4 can be write 2 raised to 2. So we get the generalized form un of x is equal to this term first, x e raised to x will be as it is minus x will be in numerator as it is, and only denominator is changed. Here we have to get the power of 2 will be 2 raised to, here 2, if here 2, then we have to get power 1, here 3, then we have to get power 2. So here if n, then we have to get the power will be 2 raised to n minus 1. So we get generalized term unx is equal to x e raised to x minus x divided by 2 raised to n minus 1, that is the nth approximation. Then for this nth approximation, if we take the limit at n tends to infinity, and that limit which is the solution of the given non-homogeneous Friedel integral equation of second kind with separable kernel. So by taking limit at n tends to infinity, we get solution, that is u of x is equal to limit n tends to infinity un x. N tends to infinity, we get solution. Okay, so limit n tends to infinity un x will be here x e raised to x minus x divided by 2 raised to n minus 1. Okay, here first term will be the constant with respect to n. So limit will be as it is, that is x e raised to x minus x, and only take the limit n tends to infinity 1 upon 2 raised to n minus 1. Okay, so we get x e raised to x minus x at n tends to infinity. Here we get 2 raised to infinity, that is infinity, 1 upon infinity, that is we get here into 0. Okay, so we get the solution is only x e raised to x, that is u of x is equal to we get x into e raised to. We can find the solution of non-homogeneous Friedel integral equation of second kind with separable kernel by using variational iteration method. Okay. In that method, we have to use the correctional functional, and using that formula of correctional functional to find the successive approximation, and from that we have to find the generalized term, that is un of x, that is nth approximation. And if we take the limit of that nth approximation at n tends to infinity, then we get the solution. Okay. So today we stop here. Thank you.